At exactly 52 past 11 a.m. on Saturday, President Yoweri Museveni officially commissioned the Nebbi substation connecting the West Nile sub-region to the high-voltage national grid.
The arguments which were being pushed by people who are saying that we had forgotten West Nile were wrong arguments. They were not serious. They were disruptive, actually.
This has been the question. You have come with the answer today, and you have switched on the region onto the national grid.
The construction of the 132 kV Gulu, Kole Gulu Nebbia Arua project has adhered fully to environmental concerns and practices.
The present-day West Nile sub-region was annexed to the British Protectorate of Uganda by the colonial government in 1914, but it has taken 110 years for this grid connection to materialize. The sub-region has for long grappled with unstable, unreliable and poor quality power supply, with leaders describing the situation as economic sabotage. The region has been connected through the 289-kilometer Gulu Nebbi Arua transmission line that has been developed at a cost of $127 million. Upon commissioning, there was change in tone of speech from the leaders.
Today is a historic change, a fundamental change in the Ministry of Energy of reaching West Nile with stable and industrially reliable electricity.
However, President Yoweri Museveni explained why the national grid extension of the region had been delayed.
There was a problem of consumption in West Nile. There was power up to Kole on the other side, Kole in Lango, where then the line goes north to Gulu. That line was a 33 kV with a weaker current. The demand in West Nile was 2 megawatts.
Transformers with the capacity to deliver up to 90 megawatts have been installed at each of the substations in Gulu, Nebbi and Arua. The Electricity Regulatory Authority, ERA Chief Executive Officer, Engineer Ziria Wako, explained the danger of installing high-voltage network in areas of low demand. According to the official statistics, the region's peak demand is seasonal and oscillates between 5.7 megawatts and 6.8 megawatts over the 12 months of the year, while the best demand ranges between 1.8 megawatts to 2.4 megawatts throughout the year. It was against this background that Museveni rallied the region to attract investments and consume this newly extended power.
Natasha Nyongozi. Congratulations. Natasha takes it all.
Accountant Natasha Nyongozi is the new Miss Uganda, having beaten 25 contestants to the crown in the wee hours of Sunday morning at Sheraton Hotel. She was followed by Ginger's Sureya Umea, 25, a cadet pilot, and Butambala's Joan Nabatanzi, 25, in first and second runner-up position respectively. For the composure, when facing a panel of judges who include former Miss World Africa Queen Abinacho during the critical question and answer session, Nyongozi had to win the tiara and a Toyota Wish car as the grand prize. Other winners of the night were Narita Martha Tusimi as Miss Congeniality, Marcia Dong, Miss Sports, Sarah Twinko Karunji for Beach Beauty, and Letaro Prisca, Queen Patience, as Miss Popularity and Miss Elite.
Children suffer a lot, irregardless of where they come from and their circumstances that they're fed in. If I led a community, I would make sure that I would create more educational centers.
My call is advocacy for children with special needs, more so those with autism. I chose this course because my little brother, Ethaniel, was diagnosed with autism at the age of 4. And it hurts my heart to see people discriminate him, especially when we go out to society.
Empathy, love is what will take us to a better step, not hatred. and envy.
Maria Mugaga Namuli was crowned Miss Talent. Suraya Umea was the top model. Patra Naluga Ataliba, Miss Personality. Esther Nalumasa Chironde, Miss Multimedia. Natasha Nyonyozi, Miss Photogenic. Joanne Navatanzi, Miss Rising Woman. And Genevieve Akello as Miss North.
Sports 2024 and 2025.
And the winner is none other than Masse Adom. Congratulations. Photogenic 2024-25, and the winner is Natasha Nyonyozi.
There were musical performances from reggae star Maddox Sematimba, whose pieces such as Namagimbi, Irene, and Take It Easy blew away the audience before Waiki Benda sealed off the evening.